It is indeed a proud moment for us at ERD Foundation today, as we have received the APSC examinations results of 2016. Many of our students had qualified, but the cherry on the top is Maria Tanin, who had not only qualified but also secured the first position of ACS APSC 2016. Congratulations, Maria, and
thank
welcome
so
once again to ERD Foundation.
Thank you.
Your success was accepted by, like, expected from all of us.
Yes.
But getting the first position.
Yes.
What would you say?
Even I was not prepared for securing first position. I was expecting a my mains went very well, and I was expecting a position. But securing first position is like the biggest achievement of my life so far. So I'm very much grateful and thankful to Almighty, my parents, my friends, and my mentors who have supported throughout my journey. So I'm very happy. You know, it's an overwhelming experience.
So Maria, why civil service?
For civil service, I have two reasons. First of all, there is a the main reason is to, like, I would get an opportunity to serve the society. Basically, it will give me an opportunity to interact with the underprivileged sections of the society. And the second reason being is that there's a lot of diversity in work, because where I had previously worked, like in Accenture, the work was very much monotonous. And here I can work with responsibility and where accountability is invisible.
So you had done a huge preparation. So
yes.
Tell us about, how did you prepare for the civil service examination?
This is my second attempt. I started my journey in 2014, where I could not make it to the final list. I was short by one mark. And then I was very much demotivated. Like, I cried a lot. I was not ready to accept the fact that I couldn't get through. But later on, gradually I realized that and my parents motivated me, and they asked me to go for a second try. And that's how I appeared in 16 batch, and I gave my all my hard work and succeeded.
So you have joined ERD Foundation, FSCC, Civil Service Coaching Center.
Yes.
And so tell us, how did that help you? You have been here with us.
Yes.
2 years.
Yes, sir.
So how did that help you in your preparation?
I have taken coaching classes for general studies and general English. My optional, I prepare on my own. And for GS, Varsha sir and other faculty members have helped me a lot. There were mistakes from my side, and they identified it, and they improved, helped in improving the same.
Any important or memorable experience you had here? Anything you can share?
Yes, when I attempted first mock test here, I made many mistakes. I didn't put the question numbers correctly.
Mm-hmm.
So sir has identified, so I didn't give him marks to get answers. Even though I wrote well, so I didn't give marks. So that, it was a nice experience. I could get to know my mistake, and I improved that.
Okay. Maria, thing is, you come from the Muslim community.
Yes, yes.
Wherein, the whole community lacks in higher education.
Yes,
and
yes.
Education as a whole.
Yes.
And what would you say, you bring from that community, cracking.
Yes.
The civil service examination?
Yes. From my place, there are still areas where women haven't come out.
Mm-hmm.
So I would like to sensitize them. And basically in Barak Valley, civil service haven't got so much importance and awareness. I try my level best to sensitize them about this service and tell them to pursue this.
Yes. It is indeed a proud moment, because not only our student, but a girl has stopped.
Yes.
The civil service.
Yes.
Examination. What are your feelings as a woman, as a girl?
I think I have justified the concept of women empowerment.
Absolutely.
Which is the main focus and overall globally. So I'm very lucky that I have been able to get through and securing first position.
Okay. But for the civil service aspirants,
yes.
What would you suggest? How would they should plan? And what would you suggest? How do they plan, seeing today's scenario and everything?
Yes. I suggest that they must choose their optional subjects very after getting a thorough study, and they should choose their optional subjects. And for GS, I would suggest that one should not study it as a subject, as a hobby. They should read it. They should try to gather as much knowledge as they can, and try to while questions are put, they try to relate it with the practical field and try to answer them with examples.
Okay.
That is the best way to.
You had been from a science background.
Yes,
you had the science background, but you had chosen pol science as your option.
Yes.
Why did you not take science and why pol science?
I've done BTech in biotechnology,
okay.
So there were no biotech subjects.
Mm-hmm.
And when I started preparing for GS, I started with Indian polity.
Okay.
So I found it very interesting. So I
so you you suggest
decided.
That you know the optional subjects should also
it should be like make
more
you
more enthusiastic about
yeah.
it. Okay, so finally your say finally to our students, what did you say Maria would say to our students?
I'd like to say that if you want to achieve your goal, you should remain focused, don't get demotivated. There will be hurdles, you have to carry on. And you have to give your best, and you have to remain determined. You have to perseverance and believe in yourself, and pursue and give your best.
So, dear students, dear ladies and gentlemen, this was Maria Tareen for you, the topper of ACS APSC examination 2016, and our own student, the student of ERDF. FSCC Civil Service Center, who had made us all proud today. And with this note, we end today's talk with Maria, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.
It was nice.